ओके तो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द प्रॉब्लम वन एन इलास्टिक मेटल। द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम वी आर डूइंग एन इलास्टिक मेटल इज सब्जेक्टेड टू द लोडिंग डज नॉट गो अंडर वॉल्यूम चेंज। ओके फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ अननोन स्ट्रेसेस एंड आल्सो फाइंड द लीनियर स्ट्रेन इन एक्स वाई एंड जी डायरेक्शन। सो इफ यू सी द प्रॉब्लम okay, so this is our problem that we have one cube like this, and they say that they have applied the load of 25 megapascal and 100 megapascal. So this is x, this is y, and this direction is z. This is okay. So in question we have the information that there is no volume change. So for no volume change, for no volume change, we know that volumetric strain must be zero. And we have derived the volumetric strain for sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z 1 minus 2 mu. We have derived this. So it is 0, 0. We can conclude sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z is equal to 0. So in x direction, my stress sigma x is minus 100 because it's compressive, plus 25. And plus sigma z is equal to 0. So this is minus 75 plus sigma z is equal to 0. Sigma z is equal to 75 megapascal. Okay? Which is in tensile nature. If the mark here is positive, that means the assume. We have assumed it to be tensile and it came out to be positive. That means our assumption is okay, that we have assumed the right. Now, in second case, we want to find out the strain in all directions. So to find the strain in all directions, strain x will be equal to sigma x by e minus mu times sigma y by E minus mu times sigma z by E. If you remember this, that we want to find out the total strain in x direction. We want to find out the total strain in x direction. Okay, so we want to find the total strain which will have the impact of stress in x direction plus stress in other directions as well. Okay, so my total strain in x direction is equal to sigma x by e minus mu times sigma y by e minus mu times sigma z by e. Okay, so we will put all the values. So my sigma x is minus 100, then my minus mu. Okay, so in question I forgot to mention that mu is given to be 0.3 and e is given out to be 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square. So these informations are given in question. So you will write mu 0.3 times into sigma y. Now sigma y is 25. 25 in positive direction, that is tensile. So we will write plus 25. Okay. And 4 divided by e, and this is minus 0.3 into sigma z is plus 75. Okay, so we just solve this. So this is minus 100 minus 0.3 into 0.3 into 25. So this is 7.5, then minus 75 into 0.3. So this is 22.5, and this is divided by e. Now what is our e? What is our E? E is 2 into 10 raised to the power 5. 2 into 10 raised to the power 5. So just solve this. Plus 7.5 plus 100. So this is 130. 130 divided by 2. 65. This will be 6.5 minus into 10 raised to minus 4. Now minus sign is indicating here that there is not expansion, there is contraction in x direction, which is but obvious because our stress, if you see that stress in x direction, this was our x direction, this was our y direction, and this is our z direction. Stress in x direction is of compressive nature. So if this is of compressive nature, then obviously our cube will contract in x direction. So this is okay. So we have calculated the strain in x direction is equal to this. Okay, now we want to calculate the strain in y direction. So we want to calculate the strain in y direction. So by using the formula which was derived earlier, so this is sigma x by E minus mu times sigma z by E. Okay, now we will take E as common. We will write sigma y. So what is sigma y? Sigma y is plus 25. Sigma y is plus 25. Okay, minus mu is 0.3 times. Okay, 0.3 times into what is sigma x? So sigma x is minus 100. Sigma x is minus 100. Okay, then minus mu 0.3 into what is sigma z? Sigma z is plus 75. Sigma z is plus 75. So we will write 2 into 10 to the power 5. This is 25 minus minus plus. So this is 30. 100 into 0.3. So this is 30. Okay, then minus 0.3 into 75. So this is 22.5. So our answer will be 25 plus 30 minus 22.5. 32.5 divided by 2. So this is 1.625 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. This is my strain in y direction. Now I want to calculate the strain in z direction. So my z direction strain will be sigma z upon E minus mu times sigma x upon E minus mu times sigma y upon E. So my sigma z is plus 75 megapascal. So we will write 2 into 10 raised to the power. Sigma z is 75 megapascal minus 0.3 into what is sigma x? Sigma x is minus 100. Okay, so sigma x is minus 100. So we will write here minus 100, then minus 0.3. Okay, now what is sigma y? Sigma y is plus 25. Okay, sigma y is plus 25. We will write here 75 plus 30 minus 25 into 0.3. That is 7.5 divided by 2 into 10 to the power 5. So this will be 75 plus 30 minus 7. Wait. 75 plus 30 minus 7.5 divided by 2. So this is 4.875 into 10 to the minus 4 is the sigma. If you write sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z, so you will see that my sigma x was minus 6.5, that is minus 6.5 plus sigma y is 1.625 plus 4.875 into 10 to the minus 4. So if you do this, minus 6.5 plus 1.625 plus 4.875, this will come out to be 0, which is a proof of no volume change. So this is how we will execute our question number one. Okay. There is some problem in the voice and some students are demanding for repeat. So I'll repeat in the end. So let's see the question number two. So question number two says there are three metal cubes A, B, C and size is 100 mm. Means one dimension is 100 mm. So if a cube four dimension will be of 100 mm. Now it says find the direct stress developed between the cubes. If this is the arrangement that there are three cubes A, B, C and Poisson's ratio for all the cubes is defined here and your Young modulus or modulus of elasticity is also defined for each and every cube. Plus it says that in y direction 50 megapascal stress has been applied in the cube B which is in center and it want us to determine the direct stress which is being developed between the two. So let's see. Question says that there are three cubes like this. This is cube number A, this is cube number B, and this is cube number C. Now this is being restrained in all the directions like this. Okay, so this is again my x direction, this is my z direction, and this is my y direction. Okay, it says that mu A, Poisson's ratio for the block A is 0.25, Poisson's ratio for block B is 0.3, and it says Poisson's ratio for block C is again 0.25. Similarly, it also defines EA, modulus of elasticity for block A is 1.5 × 10⁵ megapascal, newton per mm square. Okay, EB, modulus of elasticity for B block is 2 × 10⁵ megapascal, and EC is equal to 1.5 × 10⁵ megapascal. So, this is the information which is being given to us. Now what we will do, first we will draw the free body diagram for each and every cube. So if we draw the free body diagram, we will see this is my block A, this is my cube B, and this is my cube C, like this. So there is some stresses will develop in this x direction like this. And stresses will develop like this. This is sigma x, and the same stresses, same compressive stresses will be generated on this face. Same compressive stresses will be generated on this face. So this is sigma x. Sorry, direction will be in opposite direction. These are compressive stresses. So this is sigma x. So we are drawing the free body diagram for each and every cube. Okay, so this is sigma x and sigma x. Now this is not being restrained in the z direction and this is not being restrained in the y direction. So for this block we can say that sigma y and sigma z both are equal to 0. Sigma y and sigma z is equal to 0. But in this case B, they have given us a compressive stress of 50 megapascal. That is in Z direction. So for this block, there will be a compressive stress of sigma Z of 50 megapascal and sigma Y will be equal to 0. Okay. So we want to, we need to find out sigma x. Sigma x is the stress developed between the cubes. Okay. So what, how can we determine? We have to look for one compatibility equation. The compatibility equation says that change in length, means what? Strain in A and it can be in x direction. This is my x direction. This is my x direction. Change in length upon original length. That means it's change in x direction and it's change in qb in x direction and it's change in c in x direction. There will be individual strains in each and every cube. But if we will see the total strain, there will be no volume change. What there will be no change in length along the x direction. So we can write that change in xa plus change in b block in x direction, change in c block in x direction will equal to zero. And length is similar. Length, this is also 100 mm. This is also 100 mm. L is equal to 100 mm. This is also 100 mm. And this is also 100 mm. So we can write delta xA by L plus delta xB by L plus delta xC by L is equal to 0. Now this is nothing but the strain of the block A in x direction. This is strain of the block B in x direction, the strain of the block C in x direction, and sum of all these strains will be equal to zero. Now strain in A in x direction will be sigma x upon E minus mu times sigma y upon E, E A minus mu times mu A into sigma V upon EA. This will be equal to strain in x direction. Now we know that sigma y sigma z is equal to 0. So this term will be equal to 0. This term will be equal to 0. The strain in block A in x direction will be equal to sigma x upon EA. That means how much sigma x, sigma x needs to be determined, and EA we will substitute in later part. So this will be equal to sigma x upon what is EA. EA is given in question, that is 1.5 times 10 to the power 5. That is my strain in block A in x direction. Now strain in B, in cube B along x direction will be equal to sigma x upon EB minus mu B into sigma y upon EB minus mu times sigma z upon EB. Now see here, sigma z is equal to 50 megapascal. Sigma z is equal to 50 megapascal and sigma y is equal to 0. So sigma y is equal to 0, that means this term is 0. So we can write sigma x upon what is EB. EB is given as 2 into 10 to the power 5. This is B. So we will take EB constant. So this is 2 into 10 to the power of sigma y, sigma x minus mu times B. What is mu times B given to us? 0.3. Okay. 0.3 into what is sigma z? Sigma z is compressive of 50 megapascals. That means minus 50. Okay. Minus 50. So this is my strain in strain of block B in x direction. Similarly, I want to calculate strain of block C in x direction. So this will be sigma x upon EC minus mu C into sigma y upon EC minus mu times mu times of C block into sigma Z upon EC. Now let's see sigma y, sigma B is equal to 0. So this is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. So strain in C block in x direction will be equal to sigma x upon 1.5 times into 10 to the minus 5. Okay, so now we will combine all these. This is my equation. Let's say this is 1. So we will write here, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So we will add 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so after adding we will get minus sigma x into 10 to the power 5. Okay, we will add it. you just added everything sigma x upon ea minus sigma x upon eb plus mu b times into 50 upon eb minus sigma x upon ec. And that should be equals to 0. The only unknown in this whole equation is sigma x. When you solve this equation, you will get sigma x is equals to 4.09 newton per mm square. This is in compression. Because we have taken sigma x to be as in compression and our assumed direction is coming out to be positive. That means we can conclude sigma x is equals to compression. Okay, now you can ask for your doubt. Now you can ask for your doubt. क्वेश्चन क्लियर है, इसको कहां पर रिपीट करना है? वॉइस सी नहीं आई सही पर. किसी को कोई डाउट पूछना है तो पूछ सकते हो, और सही रिपीट करना है तो रिपीट कर सकता हूँ मैं. अदिति त्यागी रेज हैंड. यू वांट टू आस्क समथिंग अदिति? जल्दी बताओ, फिर टाइम नहीं है इसमें, ये अभी डिस्कनेक्ट होने वाला है. डू यू वांट मी टू रिपीट एनीथिंग? डू यू हैव एनी डाउट रिगार्डिंग these two questions, numerical? कोई डाउट नहीं है सर, पॉजिटिव है. देन अमूल राकेश उस पे आ जाओ ना, कॉल वॉइस पर. वॉइस पर आ जाओ डाउट पूछने के लिए. अनम्यूट कर लो. वॉइस इज नॉट वर्किंग. ओके, व्हाट यू वांट टू आस्क? पॉजिटिव है देन कंप्रेसिव. ऐसा नहीं है कि पॉजिटिव है तो कंप्रेसिव कंक्लूड किया है. डायरेक्शन अपन ऐसे ले रहे हैं कि मैंने अज्यूम किया था उसको कंप्रेसिव. यहाँ देखो, मैंने यहाँ पर उसको अज्यूम किया है कंप्रेसिव. ओके, तो मैंने यहाँ पर सिग्मा एक्स को कैसा लिया हुआ है? कंप्रेशन डायरेक्शन में. अब जब मैंने इक्वेशन सॉल्व करी तो वो पॉजिटिव आ गया. जब इक्वेशन सॉल्व करी तो वो पॉजिटिव आ गया. यानी कि पॉजिटिव आने का मतलब होता है कि अज्यूम डायरेक्शन इज करेक्ट. पॉजिटिव व्हेन यू सॉल्व एन इक्वेशन एंड अननोन साइन कम्स पॉजिटिव, दैट मीन assumed direction is correct. Okay. So we have assumed that this sigma x is compressive nature, sigma x is of compressive nature, and when we have solved by taking this compression in account, it comes out to be positive. Hence we can conclude that sigma x is compressive nature. If that has that sigma x will come out to be negative, suppose If we have solved the equation and sigma x come out to be minus 4.09, then we could have concluded that that assumed direction is incorrect. That means sigma x is not compressive, it's tensile of nature. Is it clear? Okay, so this is the question. The question says that a cylindrical bar is 20 mm in dia and 1000 mm long. During tension test, it was found that longitudinal strain is 4 times that of lateral strain. If elastic modulus is 1×10⁵ megapascal, then it says find your bulk modulus due to hydrostatic pressure of 100 megapascal in the bar. Okay, so it clearly says that there is a cylindrical bar which is 20 mm in dia and 1000 mm long. During tension test, it was determined or it was found that longitudinal strain is 4 times of lateral strain. And it says if elastic modulus is 1×10⁵ megapascal, then find the bulk modulus due to hydrostatic pressure of 100 megapascal in the bar. Okay. So let's solve this question. Okay, the solution says in question it was given that longitudinal strain is 4 times of lateral strain. Okay, so we know that lateral strain upon longitudinal strain is nothing but Poisson's ratio. That is mu. So we can write that 1/4 is equal to lateral upon longitudinal strain, that is mu. So mu is your 0.25. Okay, one thing. Then it says find out the bulk modulus. So we know that E is equal to 3 times of K, 1 minus 2 mu. This we have determined in our previous classes when we studied the relationship between elastic constant. So using this equation, we know that K is equal to E by 3 times 1 minus 2 mu. So E is given to be 1×10⁵ megapascal divided by 3, 1 minus 2 times 0.25. 1×10⁵, 3×0.5. So this is 1.5. Okay, so 10⁵, 1×10⁵ divided by 1.5. So our K value you can determine that 1 upon 1.5 is 6.67 times into 10⁴ Newton per mm square. Now it says change in volumetric strain CV. Now it says find out the change in volume. Find out the change in volume due to hydrostatic pressure. It asks for change in volume to be determined due to hydrostatic pressure of 100 megapascal in the bar. So we can write that volumetric strain is nothing but direct strain upon bulk modulus, or direct stress is given up to be minus 100, because same from all the direction hydrostatic pressure and 6.67 times into 10⁴. Okay, so my change in volume upon total volume is equal to 100, and minus sign is here only for compression. It's showing that hydrostatic pressure is applied as a compressive force. So my change in volume will be equal to minus 100 upon 6.67 into 10⁴. Now for a cylindrical volume V is equal equals to pi by 4 into d square into L. That is the volume. The change in volume will be equals to minus 100 upon 6.67 into 10 to the power 4 into pi by 4 into dia. Dia was given to us 20 mm and length was 1000 mm. So we can write that pi by 4 into 20 whole square into 1000. So that will come out to be, change in volume will come out to be minus 471.2 mm cube. This is decrease in volume. Is that clear for everyone? Is that clear for everyone?
Yes, yes sir, yes.
Is that clear for everyone? Yes.